We had separate careers in Sweden, singing in Swedish, having lots of success, both of us.
We wanted to reach other countries and not sing in Swedish. So, we have always been very, very good friends, and so we said, why not try to do something together? And so we formed Brookset in 86.
You write a song, you make a record in Stockholm, you know, and you find having success here or in Australia or wherever, Canada, whatever. It's like, it's a crazy thing. Power of music.
Cuando Roxette vino a Chile, se encontraba en la cúspide de su carrera, desarrollando su primera gira mundial que incluyó Canadá, Estados Unidos, Europa y Sudamérica y millones de unidades vendidas de sus dos últimos larga duración.
She's a little bit dangerous. And so many people here tonight. And please take it easy, we don't want anyone to get hurt. I'm sure that we are going to have a really good time anyway, okay? Hope you know this song.
Spend some time, you and I, under Oh. nos vamos a unos pequeños mensajes, pero ya estamos de vuelta con Roxette en vivo.
¡Gracias! ¡Muchas gracias!
The Big L es uno de los grandes éxitos de los últimos meses en nuestro país. Vamos a escucharlo en vivo con Roxette.
I wake up lonely. The air of silence in the bedroom and all around. Touch me now. I close my eyes and dream. Thank you.
But it's over now. not scared. Never was a quitter. Tasting like a raindrop.
Yeah.
Heavenly bound. Cause Sam's got a number when she's spinning me around. Kissing is a collar. A loving is a wild dog. She's got the look. Lover's disguise, banging on the head drum, shaking like a mad bull. She's got the look. Swinging to the bone, moving like a hammer. She's a miracle man. Loving is the ocean, kissing is the wet sand. She's got the look.
De donde están, porque muy pronto regresamos con la primera presentación de Roxette en Chile.
Thank you.
in my car. Be a rider in a love game, following the star. Pumped in a book of wisdom, I get no money talk at all. Just a train going downtown, she's got a club on the moon. And she's telling all the secrets in a wonderful balloon. She's the heart of the fun fair, she got me whistling a private tune. And it all begins where it ends. And she's all my magic friend. Okay! She says, hello, you fool, I love you. Come on, join the joyride. Join the joyride. She's the child of the sun. We're part of this together. Could never turn around and run. Don't be no fortune teller to know where my lucky love belongs. Won't know.
You're a wonderful audience. It's been a great evening. Thank you. Without playing this absolutely true story, goes something like this.
Thank you. Fell into the dark.
Perfect Day, vamos a una pausa comercial. Ya volvemos con Roxette en vivo. Look Sharp y Knocking on Every Door de Joyride.
To the soul, I find my back to the wall when it's time to go. I gotta know, is that your heartbeat? Yeah, please, be right. Can you feel all that heat and needs tonight? Alright, I'm the girl, paint your love all over my world. From the touch of your hair, I'm getting lost in the riddles of the modern man. I got it up, down, all around, tied to the bone. There's a strange situation on the late night show. I gotta know, is that your heartbeat? But you couldn't find the door, could you? Could you? Well, I'm standing in the sun, I'm
living in the rain. I gotta get it running like a human hurricane over you, over you. Now you're looking like a fox on the run, and you're faster than a shot from a gun. I'm pointing at you, oh, oh, you. I'm talking about you, yeah, you. I throw in that love in stores, keep on knocking on every door. Babe, I've seen it all before. Thank you.
Thank you. estamos todos disfrutando. Y...
Since it's already morning, I see the sky, it's so beautiful and blue. The TV's on, but the only thing showing is a picture of you. Oh, I get up and make myself some coffee. I try to read a bit, but the story's too thin. I thank the Lord above, you're not here to see me in the shape I'm in.
Estamos aquí en el estudio con Roxette, gracias a una gentileza de Lee. Y conmigo están en este momento precisamente Per Gessle.
What?
Ok. What's more? No, Ginsley. Sorpresa, estamos aquí en el estudio con Roxette, gracias a una gentileza de Jeans Lee. Así es que en este momento están conmigo Per Gessle, Mari Fredrickson, quienes se presentaron en Chile el 25 de abril en el Estadio San Carlos de Apoquindo, y ahora vamos a conversar con ellos.
What were you doing? First of all, welcome to Chile and thank you very much for joining us in this program. And what were you doing individually, first the birth and before the birth of Roxette?
Well, we had separate careers in Sweden, singing in Swedish, having lots of success, both of us. So we've been in the business for a very long time. I started out in the late 70s and Marie in the early 80s professionally. So, we had a couple of years before Roxette as well.
Okay, and how did the idea of Roxette?
It was because we wanted to start to sing in English and we wanted to reach other countries and not sing in Swedish. So, we have always been very, very good friends, and so we said, why not try to do something together? And so we formed Roxette in 86.
Well, at first you, as I know, you expected a certain success in Europe, but you never imagined what could happen later with Roxette. Is that true?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, coming from Sweden is not the easiest thing in the world when it comes to music business. You know, everything is circulating around England and America. So we sort of headed for continental Europe, and that was it, you know. So we were really surprised when America, I mean, we had four number ones in the States up to now, so.
And how do you explain the success of Roxette? Because you have a very classical concept of rock with melodies and so on. How do you explain your success in the beginning of the 90s when it was the times of the rap, the techno and the house music? How do you explain that?
Oh, it's hard to do. Maybe it's that is the reason, you know. People, there's a lot of people out there who's a little bit tired of all the dance scene and the rap thing. And if you go to a Roxette show, you find people from 10, 12 years old up to 50, 55 years old. Everyone is sort of attracted by our music, you know. And a lot of people recognize the 60s elements, the 70s, you know, and all those, like you said, when music was based around melodies and, you know, the songwriting tradition. And that's what Roxette is all about, basically.
And although both of you are European, your music, the music that you do, it has to, seems to have an American influence. Is that true?
I think it's a mix of everything in our music. I mean, both of us have grown up with American and English music. And I mean, everything from the Beatles to, I mean, Tom Petty. Okay. So, and music from the 60s and the 70s. So I think it's a mix of, but mostly I think it's European. The sound is very European, I think.
And what do you think about, for example, in the case of Chile, exactly, you are the best record sellers in this country.
Great.
Wow. Great. And now, what do you think about this? You are the best sellers in a country that's situated miles and miles away from your homeland. How do you feel about that?
That's
wild.
Yeah, it's fantastic. It's really hard to believe. I mean, it's, for us, it's so special to come here and and the whole tour here in South America feels for us very exotic, and yeah, I don't know what to say. It's fantastic.
It's crazy. I mean, you write a song, you make a record in Stockholm, you know, and you find having success here or in Australia or wherever, Canada or whatever. It's like it's a crazy thing. Power of music.
Did you ever know something about Chile before this tour?
Very little about South America. Yeah.
Well, I gotta tell you that yesterday I received a letter from Punta Arenas, that one of the southest cities in the world, and the guy was begging me to do something with you and to send him photographs and so on. So I must tell you that you're really a success here.
Okay.
Well, this tour, how has it been for you? What are the results that you've
seen? Great. We've played in Montevideo, in Uruguay, and in Paraguay, Asunción, and tonight here. Santiago. So far, really, really good.
And do you find some differences between the publics in the different countries?
Yeah, it depends what you mean. In South America, I mean, it seems to be sort of the same, but if you compare to like North America, for instance, it's people are a little quieter, you know. Some cities in Europe are really wild, like the Spanish countries, Spanish cities and Italian cities. The northern countries like Sweden and Norway are a little bit cooler.
Here they are so warm and so nice and friendly.
Yes.
And know all the songs. They sing along with all the
songs. The lyrics much better than we do, actually.
Yeah.
Yes, they know a lot of your songs,
yeah.
Of Love Sharp and Joyride.
Mm.
Now, I read some interviews where you talked about the following. You try to give an individual character to every song you make. So I would like to know what's the developing that you've seen between Pearls of Passion, Look Sharp, and Joyride.
Well, I think we started out in '86. You know, since it was the first album we did together, it was we didn't really know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
We sort of fooled around a bit and see what happened. With Look Sharp, we started to get an identity in the sound,
mm-hmm.
which we found eventually with Joyride. Joyride feels like the Roxette album for us sound-wise, and so I think the next step is going to be, since we're on doing this tour, which takes like 12 months to do, the band is tighter, you know, it's more rockier than ever, you know,
mm-hmm.
and it's going to be a little bit more harder, I think.
Well, minutes ago we were talking about the distances between Sweden and Chile and so on, and the videos have been the media to let you being in different countries at the same time. Who decides it, how the videos are done?
Well, we decided that together with the director, and we read a lot of scripts, and so we it's a teamwork actually.
Mm-hmm.
So in the end, it's always us who says yes or no. I mean, so that's very important. I mean, so.
And about the aesthetics of you, the way you look, your image, the hairstyle, the wardrobe, who decides that? Or
we do that ourselves. Yeah, I think it's very important to do that, because today so many, a lot of stylists and I mean, you have to keep your own personality and dress like you really, but you know yourself how you want to look, and I mean,
yeah.
So it's, and we have been in the business for so long, so we have a lot of experience, and now I'm 34 years old, so I have to know what I should wear.
And there's a lot of women here that's always telling me, well, Maria looks so good. How did you do that? How do you do that?
I don't know. I just try to be myself.
Okay, and what's the future of Roxette? How do you see yourselves in a couple of years?
Oh, who knows? You know, anything can happen. I think this tour finishes off in late July, and then we're going to take a break, you know.
Mm-hmm.
We start recording in early next year, probably have a new album out next year. And then we'll see, maybe come back here and play.
Do you have a little eye or concept of what it will be about, the new album?
No, the ambition is to make a better album than Joyride, you know. And you always want to improve all the time, you know, the writing and the recordings and everything.
Don't you think it's going to be a little hard to do something better than Joyride?
Yeah, I mean, it depends on what you mean. I mean, it's hard
mm-hmm.
to keep up a level of, I mean, Joyride is like 9 million worldwide. And you can't sort of keep a level on selling that many records all the time, all your life. You have to be prepared to sort of slow down a bit. But that doesn't mean that the records has to be worse. I mean, the record, you can develop your talents and your ambitions all the time without sort of improving your sales results. So it depends on what you want to do.
Okay, many people are just asking here, is wondering, what are you, your friends, your couple, your workmates, what is it?
We're just working together. We're very good friends. And
because you've been many years together.
Yeah. So it's just a working relationship.
And a very good working relationship.
Yeah, very good.
What would you like to say to the public in Chile? To those kids that get you to the best seller?
Well, of course, we want to thank you all. And thank you for waiting so long for us. And it's going to be great tonight, I'm sure.
And would you like to say to them and hello in Swedish, or tell them something in Swedish?
Ja, det kan vi väl göra. Vi kan väl säga hej och det är kul att vara här, och vi hoppas att ni kan komma till Sverige en gång och dricka kaffe hemma hos Marie.
What does it mean?
You ask them home to my house drinking coffee.
They can come to Sweden and have coffee at Marie's place.
Okay, thank you very much,
okay.
And we hope you will be back very, very soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Eso sería la entrevista con Roxette. Y ojalá la hayan disfrutado y espero que ustedes se sumen con nosotros y lo esperemos. Chao.
Okay, thank you very much, Roxette.
Thank you.
Thank you very
okay.
much.
Bye,
bye. 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 Eduardo?
Sí. Arréglale el micrófono, Pablo.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot. Take care.
Have good luck this night.
Thank you.
We'll be there.
Yeah.
Bye.
Le está rozando con el... Pónselo afuera. Pónselo afuera, Pablo.